Hi, my name is Erin Carlson. This is my 15th year of teaching. I currently teach Spanish at the University of South Carolina, and over the summer of 2017, I had the extreme pleasure, the extreme good fortune, the most wonderful experience ever of having won a Scholz scholarship to study at Academia Latinoamericana in Cusco, Peru. It was an amazing experience, and I am so grateful to Scholz for the opportunity. As a language teacher, as someone who studied abroad in college way, way back when, I know that study abroad is important. I've told my students, I have preached this gospel to them over and over and over again. For so many reasons, it is important for students to study abroad. It improves their language skills if they go to the country of the language where they're studying. That's a given. It gives them another point of view, and it gives them the ability to see multiple points of view. It increases their critical thinking skills because they can see things from different angles and have different ideas. It gives them an appreciation and respect for new cultures, for other cultures, because everything is going to be different from you know where they come from where we come from, to where the students are going. Even if it's not drastically different, even the small things, like the menu board at McDonald's being different, or you know, just how cities are set up, or using public transportation, or just any of those small things that can really surprise a student when he or she gets there. You know, just, and things still surprise me to this day. Still surprising, especially when I got to Cusco and I realized really just how much I loved it. I mean, there's just something about immersing yourself in another culture. There's just something about immersing yourself in your language. And for me, that was my personal goal. When I applied for the Scholz scholarship, my personal goal was immersion back into the language. It'd been a long time since I'd really been to a Spanish speaking country and really spoken Spanish with Spanish speakers. My husband doesn't speak Spanish. I have a daughter. You know, I speak Spanish to her. She's two. So we're just getting to language. We're just getting to spoken language now. But I needed to get back to having an authentic experience in a Hispanic culture. And so I was really excited when this opportunity came up. So when I won, I was so excited. I was so excited. I danced and sang and told people over and over again how excited I was that I'm going to go to, you know, I'm going to Peru. I'm going to Cusco and go see Machu Picchu. It's going to be amazing. But as the dates drew closer, admittedly, I got warier and warier. I was going to leave my daughter for 2 weeks. I'm leaving my husband for 2 weeks. You know, it's 2 weeks in the middle of the summer. I could be taking grad classes. I could be doing this. I could be doing that. I was scared. I'd never been to Peru. I'd never been to Peru before. I'd never been to South America before. And less experienced travelers left terrible things on the internet, and it just made me nervous. And then, 2 weeks before I was supposed to go to Cusco, a former student of mine, a young man I'd had for Spanish 1 and Spanish 3, and then he came back to visit me every summer since he graduated, who double majored in, well, I guess you would call it triple majoring, biochemistry and then in Spanish. He did the Auxiliaris program in Spain on my recommendation. He was in Cusco. He was doing medical research, serving the indigenous women who don't have good access to medical care. And while he was there, he went for a hike, which is something he loved to do, and up in the beautiful Andes Mountains. And he fell. And he died. And it broke my heart. And I'll never be the same. And I just knew that was a sign that I wasn't supposed to go. But my husband, my friends, even people I hadn't spoken to in a long time, really rallied around me and told me that I needed to go. And I'm so glad that I did, because it was a life-changing experience. I cannot honestly begin to put into words, but I'll try. First and foremost, one of the reasons I was super nervous is that I would be living with a host family. I never did that before. I lived in a residency when I did my study abroad in Spain, and whenever else I traveled, I stayed in hotel rooms. So host family, it was a scary idea because you never know what you're going to end up with someone else's family. And everybody's family's crazy, but my family was amazing. I loved them. Maritza, Renato, Renatito, Magali. Oh, I loved them so much. They had the best food and my room was so fantastic. And I had a hot shower, which was amazing. And my little mom, she really was very little. She was so sweet and so kind, and the kids were so sweet and so kind, and I just had a wonderful time with them. They absolutely made 75% of the trip. The school was fun. Academia Latinoamericana, it's a small school, so it's very familial. So even the students I didn't have class with, because my class was very small, even the students I didn't have class with, like I lived with other students, and you know, they made friends, then we made friends, and then we would all hang out or hang out between classes, and it was just really nice. I really liked it. It's centrally located. It's a beautiful little school. I liked it very much. The classes were interesting. I did a class on the Incan culture. Fascinating. I learned so much. I mean, just absolutely makes me want to go back and study more. Makes me want to pick up books. Makes me want to do more research, which I have. I have since then done lots of research and reading, just because I'm curious and want to know more. I also did a Spanish literature course. And so obviously we all did those in college and they were fantastic. I made some wonderful new friends. I'm not sure whether it was intentional. It seems like it was, but there were other teachers who had won other scholarships, one from the Northeastern area, one from the Midwest, one from the Northwest, and then someone from Texas. And we really bonded, and it was a really amazing experience. Just being able to talk about being a teacher and like the need to re-immerse ourselves. It was fantastic. And what we did was we stayed in Spanish the entire time. That was our goal. We spoke in Spanish. We texted in Spanish. It was always, always, always in Spanish. We explored the city by day. We went to museums. We went to cafes. We went to the markets. We did wonderful things, had lunches with our family. We had class in the afternoons. And then every night we went out and explored a new restaurant, had delicious authentic cuisine. I had delicious ceviche. I had delicious lomo saltado. I had delicious things with haba beans. I mean, so much good food in Peru. And I was really worried because I don't like weird foods. But the food in Peru was amazing. So definitely worth it. But more than anything else was really growing those friendships with those new people. And then, of course, I'm in Cusco. I have to go see Machu Picchu. And it was a dream come true. A dream come true. Why would a girl from Anderson, South Carolina, with a dad who didn't graduate high school, and a mom who graduated high school and went straight to work in a factory, and an older brother who didn't graduate high school, why would I ever go to Machu Picchu? How did the stars align for that to be my life? I'll never understand, but I'm so grateful that it did. Life-changing experience that was just further enriched by the other sites in and around the Sacred Valley that I got to see through school, that I got to see with my family. I look at these architectural sites and I think, man, the Inca were amazing, just absolutely amazing. And to think that the Spanish thought that they were like savages, that they were underdeveloped, it's bananas. You can see through, you know, what's left behind, just how amazing and just conceptually just intricate everything that they did was. It was very smart. I was so sad to leave. My last night, I didn't want to go home. The next day, I didn't want to. I was sad. I was very sad. I was practically sick to my stomach. I was so sad. I was excited to see my husband and my daughter, obviously, but I was so sad to leave my family, and I was so sad to leave my friends. Just knowing that this was an incredible, once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and you know, I still talk to my family and friends via WhatsApp. You know, I love them. They're sweet, and they're a forever part of my lives. The experience reminded me, I think more than anything else, that I'm not just a person who speaks Spanish, but I am a Spanish speaker. Spanish is part of who I am. It's part of the fabric of what makes up Erin. And it really reminded me of that and kind of relit that fire and relit that spark, because I think for me, Spanish had gotten to be something that was academic, and now it's part of my life again. And it really revived my energy and my enthusiasm to teach and connect with students and to show them why learning Spanish is a gift and a joy. Yes, it can help you, but just the act of learning the language in and of itself can be wonderful. And then the gateway that it opens up for you is even better. So it was an amazing experience. Again, I'm so very thankful. And here are some pictures of my experience, and I hope that you enjoy them. Thank you so much.